hear one more story, my child? Well then, here's one. You remember Grandmother Eleanor, don't you? This is her story. It all began when a thief stole the king's most valuable item. Your grandmother was a little girl. She spent her days playing with her best friend, a young elf. The king searched everyone in the castle.
Show me your bag.
Until he uncovered the elf's treachery, the mage, the king's closest advisor, ordered the young elf's arrest. The elf did not resist, but his eyes burned with hatred.
Your Highness, I have served your father for many years, ever since he saved my life. He is a good man. And I know he will win this wretched war. I must prepare for his reception. He should be arriving soon with his mage. Did you finish your embroidered portrait for him?
Princess, I tried so hard to reach you. I'm sorry I can't speak. My flask is empty. I need water. We were winning the battle, but then we fell into a trap. Your father is in critical condition. He wants to see you. Please, help me bandage my shoulder so I can open a portal to him. Thank you, Princess. Come along. We must hurry. Thank you for being so helpful, Princess. Now, I have a surprise for you.
Ah, but I promised to show you your father. I'm hoping you'll be more willing to end this war than they were. Join me here as my bride, and I will set them free. I have much to do now. I'll leave you here to think about my offer.
Princess, the spirits contacted me. They wish to help you. Listen carefully if you want to save your father. Find a fire flower in the hall. You'll know what to do after that. I am at your command, Princess. You wish to see where your father is, so be it. Burn his image here, and the flower will point the way.
Daughter.
There isn't much time left. Now you know where your father is. Get through the portal, quickly!
Hello again, Princess. Yes, I am loyal to that elf, but don't fret. You've always been kind to me. You may roam, but I must guard this portal with my life. Fetch me some water. Here, you may have this.
Thank you.
At last we meet. I see you found the shrinking potion. It is very powerful. Be careful with it, and only use it when you must. You won't be able to make more. You're on the right track. Your father is close. But first, the spirits wish to help you further. Find green and yellow keys from the fountain. Well, Princess, now we will reveal the most important detail, the greatest danger you face. Open the fountain, pour in the royal blood, and watch.
Forgive me, my lord. She has escaped.
Escaped? Well, she won't get very far. If you want something done right, see to it yourself.
Find the princess!
Capture princess.
Princess, time is short. Go, I'll stall them. Here, this magic butterfly will help you pass through the poisonous fog.
Excuse me, can you please help me down? Dernwark strung me up here because I refused to serve him, but he used to be such a nice lad when he was young. Will you help me? I promise I won't be a burden. You're too kind, Princess. I'm Tom. May I accompany you? I'll do whatever I can to help you.
cannot escape. Now, let us return. I swear no harm shall come to you. Eleanor!
Greetings, Princess. It was I who sent that bird to help you. I am Camille, the Forest Witch, and I want to help you. Your father and his mage are imprisoned in the tower on the other side of my enchanted forest. There's an old map on my desk that you may use. Follow the clues, and you'll find the right path.
Thank you.
I see you passed my little test. Here, this crystal will help you activate the portal, and my map will reveal the hidden tower. But remember, simply rescuing your father and the mage will solve nothing. The true solution lies in the past. Only by changing the past will you save your kingdom.
Princess, I overheard your conversation with Camille. If you want to travel through time, you should speak to the old druid. He lives in my village. It's not far from here. But first, let's find your father and the mage.
Eleanor, you're alive. Don't worry about me. Find the druid. He's a good friend of mine. He'll surely help you. Then return here. There is much I must tell you.
welcome to my village.
That's strange. It's deserted. Let's head to the square. The old druid usually meditates there. We can ask the guard what happened here as well.
Halt! Who goes there? Hmm? You want information? It's not free. Give me something shiny first. How generous. Here, this opens the gates. Everyone's gone because they're out looking for that princess that escaped. I should look too. Ciao!
Princess, I see you found your father. He's right. I can help you. The gnome's statue hides a secret passage to the Cave of Portals, but you must discover how to open it. Here, you'll need this.
Yes, this is the cave of portals he mentioned. No one's used them for centuries. You see, time is fickle, Princess. Changing the past can save lives, but it can also ruin them as well. You must be careful.
Well done. Now if you activate the red portal, it will take you to the past. But see your father first. He has something to say.
It's good to see you, Eleanor. Thank you for freeing me. While I was imprisoned, I had much time to think about the past and Delmong's vengeful motives. I fear I may have judged him too hastily, but that theft could have been devastating. Once our kingdom was full of peace and happiness, until evil forces arrived, bringing suffering and war. I was the only one who could fight them. A great battle began as I faced their leader in hand-to-hand combat. He was fierce and cunning, but at last I dealt him a mortal blow. I thought he was slain, but he struck one last time, mortally wounding me in return. As I lay dying, a fairy appeared. She saved me by sealing my wound into that powerful artifact. If it is ever broken, I will perish. So I've guarded it with my life. Now you see why losing that artifact made me so paranoid. But since you found the portals, you can uncover the true thief. This crystal will allow you to travel back in time to the day the artifact was stolen. You'll need a second crystal, but it fell through the grating. Good luck, my dear. Thank you.
I'll stash the artifact here until I put Delmorg to sleep with my potion. Then I'll put it in his pocket. I don't want to hurt Delmorg, but he saw me. I must convict him. Perhaps some chamomile tea will ease my mind.
Now you know the truth. Go to the tower. The mage is there. Once you speak with him, you can return and open the green portal. You are the only one who can save our future.
Hello, Princess. Now you know what happened that fateful day. I truly regret my deed, but it was not done without reason. Long ago, my brother contracted a disease that no doctor could cure. I had given up hope until a creature appeared, offering me a deal. He would give me the cure for my brother's illness, but in return, I must one day do him a favor. My brother lay dying, so I agreed. My brother was cured instantly, but just as quickly, I forgot my promise. When the creature returned, he demanded the king's artifact. I could not refuse, so I stole it. Unfortunately, Delmorg the elf saw me. I feared he'd tell the king, so I set him up. But what's done is done. I will pay for my mistakes. But I don't wish your father or Delmorg to suffer any longer. You must go back in time and find evidence to prove my guilt to His Majesty. This crystal will help you get there, but you need one more, and that crafty bird out there stole it. What a breakthrough! This magic mirror will change everything.
Just leave it here, Marvin. I'll check it later. I'm exhausted, and I must rest.
Sleep tight. Once my sleeping potion kicks in, I'll sneak into your bedroom and take the key to your artifact. No one will suspect me.
Thank you.
This cabinet lock is quite complex, but I could make a duplicate key in my chamber.
Thank you. Show me your bag. I must apologize for my accusation. I hope you can forgive me. As for you, Marvin, I see now how difficult your situation was, but you also helped my daughter to correct your past mistakes, and for that, I forgive you.
And that's your grandmother's story. Hmm? What happened to Delmorg the Elf? Well, because he was never blamed, he stayed friends with the princess and grew up to be a kind and wise man. This is her doll. May it remind you that love can mend the errors of the past and change our future.